Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about timer tasks in Java. And at the end of this video, we're going to work on a project where we can have a countdown timer that will display Happy New Year on New Year's Eve. So let's get into it. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, everybody, I have two definitions here for you. The first is timer, and this is a facility for threads to schedule tasks for future execution in a background thread. And basically what this means is that it keeps track of the time in a background thread. And then we have timer task, and this is a task that can be scheduled for one time or repeated execution by a timer. So this is a class that contains an abstract method called run, and when our timer reaches a certain point, a certain time, it will execute a task either once or repeatedly, and we can have that task be whatever we want. So we're going to have a timer task that is linked to a specific timer. So let's begin by creating an instance of a timer. So we're going to type in timer, and let's just call this timer with a lowercase t, equals new timer, and this will just keep track of the time, but we'll need an import, so let's add that now. So import java.util.timer. Now we're going to create a timer task. So let's add that to the next line. So timer task, and let's call this task equals new timer task. Then a set of parentheses. Then we'll need an import for this as well. So make sure that you have these two imports. Now an easy implementation of the timer task is to add an anonymous inner class. So with this timer task, we're just going to add a set of curly braces after this. And then we need to add unimplemented methods, and it's just the run method. So this timer task is going to be linked to this timer. So when time is up, it's going to execute this run function here. So when our timer reaches a certain point, it's going to execute this run function of our timer task instance. So you can do whatever you want within this run function, but let's just start with something simple for this demonstration. So I'm just going to create a simple print line statement that says task is complete. Now what we'll want to do is link this task to this timer. So we can use the schedule function of this timer instance. So I'm going to add that after our timer task. So type in the name of the timer dot, and we can use the schedule function. And there's a few options here if you have IntelliSense. There's a few variations and different ways to do this, but we're going to start with something simple. So this schedule function has two arguments, a task and a time, and you can see that it filled in the tasks that we're going to use within this first argument, and the second is a time. So this is normally in milliseconds. So if you were to set this to zero and we ran our program, this run function is going to execute immediately. So let's try it, and our task is complete. Now this is a delay, the second argument. So if we were to set this to 3000 milliseconds, there would be a 3 second delay. So you can see that it's not doing anything right now because it's waiting, and once that delay is over, then it executes our task. So for our next example, I just turned this line into a comment. So you don't have to necessarily just pass in only a numeric value. We can pass in a date here if we want this task to be completed at a certain date in the future. So we can actually do that utilizing the calendar class. So let's create an instance of the calendar class and set the date. So we're going to type in calendar, and let's call this date equals calendar.getInstance. And then we're going to set things such as the year, the month, the day, the hour, so on and so forth. So we're going to type in the name of this instance, dot set. And then within parentheses, we're going to type in calendar dot. And there's a few recommendations here if you have the IntelliSense setup. So let's set the year, and this is all in caps. And then we're going to add a comma, then we'll set this for 2020. And then we're going to do the same thing for like the month, the day of the month, the hour, so on and so forth. But I'm also going to change the clock on my computer just to demonstrate this. So let's have this task perform at like midnight this day, basically. So we're going to do the same thing here. And let's set the month. So month, and let's set this to June. So that would be calendar.June. And let's set the day of the month. So day of month. And we'll set this to June 20th. And then we'll do hour of day. So this is in military time. So if you want midnight, that's going to be zero. So it's 0 through 24, basically. And let's set the minutes. So calendar.minute. And we'll set this to 0. Then you can do seconds as well. So second. We'll set that to 0. And then milliseconds. Okay, so this task is going to execute at midnight, June 20th of the year 2020. So I'm actually going to fast forward the clock on my computer to demonstrate this. But first, we actually need to add this task. So we'll add that after here. So timer.schedule task. And then for the time, what we're going to write is date.getTime. And that's it. So let's run this. Okay, so here I changed the clock on my computer to just a minute before midnight. So once it hits midnight, it's going to execute this task. So we got 3 seconds, 2, 1, 0. Task is complete. Now for our third example, we're going to use a different method of the timer class, and that is the schedule at fixed rate method. And what this allows us to do is to repeat a task every so often. And I think this would be good for some sort of like countdown timer. So let's create something like that. So timer.schedule at fixed rate. So this will take a task, the time or delay of the first instance or when you want this to be executed. And we're going to set this to 0 for now. And this third value is how often do you want this repeated? Let's say that we want this to repeat every 1 second. So we'll put 1000 here for 1000 milliseconds. So this run method is going to execute every second. So let's create a countdown timer. So we'll create a variable within here and let's call it counter and set this equal to 10. And within this function, let's create an if statement in place of this. So if counter is greater than 0, what we'll do is that we will just display whatever our counter is, and then maybe add seconds. And then we want to decrement our counter by 1. So counter minus minus. All right, so this is just going to keep on running. So we'll want some way to cancel our timer. So we'll add an else statement. And then within here, why don't we display something such as Happy New Year? So we'll system.out.println. Happy New Year. And then in order for our timer to stop, we type in the name of our timer dot cancel. All right, so since there's no delay on this, this is going to begin immediately when we run this. So let's try it. So it began at 10 seconds and it's going to keep on going down until it reaches 0 and then display Happy New Year. So 2, 1, Happy New Year. Now let's take this a step even further. So let's have this task begin right before New Year's Day, like 10 seconds before New Year's Day on New Year's Eve. And then we'll have a countdown timer. And then once it hits 0, midnight of New Year's Day, it's going to display Happy New Year. So we can use schedule at fixed rate. And for the delay, we're going to use date.getTime. So I'm just going to copy this, paste it underneath for our next example, and we're going to use date.getTime in place of our delay here, and then we're going to set the day that we want this to begin. So let's set this to, let's set it to 2020, calendar.December, day of the month, the 31st, hour of the day, so this is in military time, so 23, minutes, 59, and then seconds, let's put 50 here. Okay, so I'm going to move the clock on my computer ahead to just before this time. Hey, you know what? Why don't I show you guys how to change the time on your computer? So I'm currently doing this with Windows. So I'm going to hover over the time, right click, adjust time. And I'm going to set the date and time manually. And let's change this to December 31st of the year 2020, 11:59 p.m. And let's change it and run this. Okay, so let's see the time right now. Okay, so we have about a minute. I'm just going to fast forward this video. All right, everybody, our task is about to begin right about now. So 10 seconds, 9 seconds, 8 seconds. I'll shut up now. So 4, 3, 2, 1, Happy New Year. All right, everybody, well, that's the basics of timer tasks. So you can execute some block of code either once at a specific time or immediately or repeatedly, either immediately or at a set date in the future. So if you want a copy of all this code, I'll post this in the comments down below. And yeah, that's the basics of timer tasks in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.